Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force. Today's objective to accomplish is Operation Wildcat. Attack and destroy an enemy firebase. Now, one of the firebases, I've been hearing that for a long time now. I guess we will see what it is once we check out the mission briefing. Speaking of, let's check it out right now. I think this is the penultimate mission, or maybe it will unlock the penultimate mission, but who knows. For now, let us just open this up. Mission: attack and destroy an enemy firebase, designated objectively. Execution: Black Widow will insert you into a narrow valley approximately 270 meters northeast of objectively. Proceed southwest approximately 65 meters. Pick a vantage point on the bluff. Okay. And eliminate enemy soldiers visible across the river. Swim across the river and proceed up the bluff, attacking the firebase from the northeast corner. So first we need to eliminate enemy soldiers from an overwatch position. That would be point number 3. And then we proceed into the objective. I wonder if you can swim in this mission, or if you drown underwater, or if you can even go into the water in this mission. I haven't tried that yet. I guess we will for the first time today. Unless there's a bridge, of course. All enemy soldiers at the objective must be eliminated in order for this mission to be a success. Of course, they need to. That is like standard protocol for Delta Force anyway. Expected enemy forces. Air photographic reconnaissance of the base shows it to be heavily fortified. Pinpoint photography shows a fortified bunker complex in the center of the objective. In addition, bunkers have been identified along the perimeter. Infrared photography has identified a barracks. Analysis of these photos indicates that the fire base is protected by 3 squads of infantry. So it's just, what, 12 people? 6 people? 36 people? Anyway. A squad of light armored vehicles has also been identified. Allied support. Alpha team will be inserted approximately 325 meters southeast of objectively. They will proceed northwest to the firebase. Their attack will commence after yours. I see. Situation. With their back to the wall, rebel forces have launched an all-out offensive in an attempt to capture the capital city of Tashkent. Really? Allied lines for the moment have been cut in two. Okay. With the southernmost allied units being hit from both the front and the rear, it is imperative that something be done to relieve the pressure. A key rebel firebase has been identified through the analysis of satellite images of the Chandro area. US Special Forces Command has been tasked with the destruction of this facility. I suppose the firebase is pretty much a forward operating base or something along those lines. Now, why too high am I being suggested a Heckler & Co. MP5 here? No. This gun sucks. I'm supposed to take enemies out from across the river. This gun sucks at doing anything. Its effective range is 100 meters. It's practically a pistol that has automatic fire capability. No, I do not want this gun. This would probably be better suited to sniping, but no. What I want is this right here. And the sidearm would be the Spec Ops 45. Except current gear. I cannot believe they would recommend that I take a gun like that. I mean, they have done that before, but yeah. Delta Force really messes with you sometimes. A really pretty sunset.
All King elements, weapons free. Secure the base.
Roger, King 6. Proceeding to Overwatch position.
This is Alpha, moving north towards the objective.
Checkpoint Bravo. I can already see a bunker, but I cannot see enemies inside of it. I suppose there's nobody in there. At any rate, let me just switch over to single fire.
Base is alert, base is alert. Bravo is compromised.
Alpha 1 is down!
What do you mean Bravo is compromised? Stealth was never a perimeter for this mission. Can you stop lagging, please? A few missions ago, this game starts dropping frames, and this time around, the game starts lagging. And I do not appreciate that one bit. Just to make it known. Now, why would they give me and recommend a Heckler & Co. MP5 for this particular mission is completely beyond me. I wonder if, do they actually call it Heckler & Co. or do they call it Heckler & Koch? I do not know. Those guys are playing around in the water, let them play. We will go ahead and stick on objective right here. Stay on objective. And continue firing at this base. I cannot see, the problem is, from this bluff over here, I cannot see any enemies. Much less take them out. So, I guess what I really need to do is just move forward. I can hear enemies firing shots at me. I do not see them. I do not know where they are. Ah, there you are. Are you not dead? Yes, you are. Good, good, good. Where's the other guy? There should be another guy right here. Now this gun is pretty much the one where you get plentiful ammo with the double load ammunition option. Even otherwise, I mean, yeah, you probably do get more ammo with something like the LMG, but with this gun, the ammo is actually usable. Now to find out whether one can swim on this map. Can I swim? Am I swimming right now? Or am I just running underwater? I do believe I'm running underwater, aren't I? Yes, I'm running underwater. I could not swim. I wonder how did I not drown? And how could I run so effectively underwater? Anyway, I cannot see any enemies thus far. Not ones that is shooting at me at least. And proceeding to free the base of its tyrants. This base could definitely use better leadership. And better people to operate it. I do not see any enemies here thus far. Should be a lot more people inside of that house over there. I just have to proceed with caution. Pretty sure I'm gonna get shot and killed the first few times around. But there's nothing. That's not gonna stop me from trying though. I do not see anybody. And that is pretty much the charm of bunkers. That you do not see anybody from the outside. Only once you start checking grenades in. Can one of these grenades go inside, please? I suppose not. Oh, there you are. I'm pretty sure that guy cursed something in his blood. Whatever they speak in Uzbekistan. And I think this guy's finally dead. If he's not, I don't know what will kill him. Did not exactly want to waste any grenades there, but ended up having to anyway. Primarily because I was tossing them from too far. That is another person, I do presume. Who is dead? I think he got shot in the foot. Ah. Greetings to you as well. There you are. Now, one of the things about this game is, and I cannot say this enough times, but it's difficult to notice where the enemies are. One more enemy over there. I think those barricades I have cleared already. I am getting shot at quite a lot, but I do feel like this. I am safe here, at least for the time being, so I will just keep staying here. Oh, where else are you guys? Where else are you guys? I cannot see anybody in there though. is like one of the main areas where enemies can be. That guy's also dead, a very small window for me to exploit. Now I wonder who's shooting at me at this point. Somebody right here? Oh, okay. I see. Didn't even know you existed. My bad. Now I could probably circle around a little and see what else in store this place has for me. Hopefully I won't get just randomly killed, shot and killed, I mean. Cannot see anybody else inside the bunker from this angle. And good thing that we do not have any time limits on this mission either. Unlike the previous few missions where I was constantly being rushed, reloading. There you are. Enemy down, enemy down. How peaceful it sounds though. Oh, come on. I'll get you. Sooner or later, I will get you. That is a promise. There probably are a few people inside that house as well. Those are not enemies. This mission seems to be pretty simple thus far. But don't let me jinx it. Pretty sure it could be far more complicated than it is already. I hope that building is not a structurally elaborate complex. Enemy. Why are my shots always on target? I wonder. I just been acing the sniper of the previous mission. You know, acing the sniping at the previous mission. But this time around, somehow, I'm sucking with basic shots. Is that? Yes, that is a running enemy. I shot too far. Too fast. Finally, bullseye. Anybody here? None that I can tell. None that I can see, at least. Let's keep circling around the base, trying to find new enemies to slaughter. That is another enemy. Down. Neutralized. Killed it. Should be at least another enemy, somewhere in the tents over there. There is another bunker over there as well. We need to eliminate people inside the bunker as well. Now, as far as I know, there were some people running around here. There seem to be more people inside of that building there. We just need to be a little careful in how we approach them. Too brash an approach can mean the elimination of our forces. Enemy not spotted yet. Pretty sure there is one in there. I saw an enemy inside the school over there. Eliminated. No enemies visible from this angle. Not inside the bunker anyway. I doubt there are any more enemies inside the bunker. I think there was only one enemy. It says that the enemy is probably inside this tent right here. Maybe this tent or that tent, either of these tents. But inside the tent, for sure. Not inside... this place actually has stairs for us to check out as well. Enemies inside this tent. This tent right here. Actually, it should be near the entrance of this one. Huh, there is no entrance on that side. So the enemy is somewhere right here. Let us go ahead and use a grenade to kill them. That did not work. Of course it did not. That was one of the most comical death screams that I've ever heard. And I think the exterior has almost been cleared. There's one enemy in the corner over there. I don't know what he's doing or why he's all the way over there, but yeah, there is one enemy in the very corner over there. We shall return to you later, house. First, I should go ahead and take this guy out. This guy who has killed my friends must be made to pay. A little far, a little off the beaten path. I do not think we need to take him out, but just to be sure, I'll just go ahead and do it anyway. I'm hoping that this guy does not kill me because he has successfully killed my friends. So, yeah. I think everybody inside the bunkers is also dead. Nobody inside the bunkers anymore. That is Alpha 1. The enemy should be somewhere over here then. Is that the enemy? I think that was. Yeah, I think that is the enemy. Nothing over there. Wait. Yep, that is Alpha 2. This is the enemy. The enemy is probably lying in the dirt, making it difficult for us to attack him head on. But we're gonna do that anyway. And thank you for coming. I've now officially avenged the death of Alpha 1 and 2, even though I probably didn't need to take a detour for that and make this video longer than it's supposed to be. Wildcat is apparently the name of the mission, and I had forgotten all about it already. Operation Wildcat. Oh, there is an opening on the first floor where you can shoot him. So this is probably going to be nice, being able to shoot in grenades all across the house. Because, yeah, I'm not going to step inside of the building to clear it. I'm just going to shoot my grenades and be done with it. Stepping inside any of these places to clear them is paramount to suicide. And you should avoid it as much as possible. Now, I think that took out one guy. I'm not sure. I'm uncertain yet. I do not see anybody inside of this bunker here. Not thus far anyway, but there could be more people there.
King 6 to all elements, objective secured. Move to primary extraction point.
King 6, this is Bravo 1. There are no other elements on scene apart from Bravo 1. Bravo 1 moving to extraction. Over and out. Mission statistics, number of kills 34, Bravo team's destruction of the firebase is just what the doctor ordered. With the pressure from enemy reinforcements removed, allied ground units have been able to regroup and rejoin the lines. The rebel attempt to capture Tashkent has been stopped. With this threat eliminated, we are one step closer to ending the civil war. As soon as current operations in the central and eastern portions of the country are completed, we'll be able to make our final assault. We believe that the remaining forces will be led by the rebel general who started the civil war. His personal unit is an elite corps of specially trained soldiers. We have been listening to that for maybe the past 4 or 5 missions now. They will not give up unless their leader is eliminated. And with that, I think we have officially unlocked the final mission of attack and destroy the remaining elite core of enemy fighters and hopefully catch the general while at it. Or maybe there will be one more mission unlocked somewhere in this vicinity for us to complete. But Operation Wildcat was actually pretty simple, very easy. It was, I don't know whether that was just my experience, but the mission was super easy. I finished it in one try. So yeah, it was simple. It was exceedingly simple, but and a little too well balanced, I would say. But anyway, I will see you guys later. That was it for today. And next time we come over, we will be covering Operation Kodiak. Until then, thank you for watching. Take care and farewell, fellow Earthlings.